opponent to Allah. It was impossible for him to have become a prophet against Allah, leaving his world or having disagreement with the Holy Quran and the Sunnah. So the word Nabiyabadi means, according to him, in the light of all this, no prophet can ever come who will have any disagreement with my Sharia or my traditions or my Sunnah. If somebody comes who is in complete agreement with the Holy Quran and the traditions and the acts of Ahlul-Sallam and his conduct, that is not against Ahlul-Sallam in any way. So, such a prophet can come. So, also the question of the Messiah coming and remaining the prophet is solved with this instrument. Because all the ulama, when we raise the question, how can he come after Ahlul-Sallam, insist that there is no harm because he will become a Muslim and will become totally subordinate to Ahlul-Sallam. So the most important thing is subordination to him. So the word Ba means Mukhalifa. No one can come who will be against him or against his Sharia or outside the yoke of his Sharia. If he is completely submissive and subordinate, there is no harm. So only in that light can that tradition about Ibrahim be solved. Now, there is another very interesting aspect to be brought to mind, to be kept in mind, and that is the tradition belonging to Hadhrat Ibrahim's possible life and becoming a prophet occurred after the Nasir was revealed to him. This verse of the Holy Quran was revealed to the Holy Prophet of Islam in year 5 Hijrah. And Hazrat Ibrahim, his son, died in the later part of the 8th Hijrah or early part of the 9th. So already he was 4.5 years old, as the traditionists tell us, when he died. 4.5 years after the birth of the beginning of the year. After the sin of the Lord, I understood the full meaning of the verse of the Lord. But at the end of this time of the fallen time, that is one thing which cannot be denied. So Allah has given him the ayat of Hatam and Nabi, more than half years preceding the death of his son. And when he died, he said, "Have you lived? You will not become a prophet." So Imam Ali Khari raises this question and argues that some people believe that he said it only in the sense that Allah made him die, because if he had lived, he would have become a prophet. You know, that is the one meaning offered by one explanation. And Mirza Ali Khari just laughs at it, just ignore this as a senseless explanation, because according to his logic, it is impossible for Ahlul-Sallam even to mention this possibility. Allah does not make people die lest they should become this and that. Prophethood is a gift of Allah. If we have decided not to bestow prophethood on anyone, how could Ibrahim have prophethood from him if he had lived? What is absurd? Moreover, if Ahmad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told definitely and categorically that there would not be any prophet after him, what he should have said, well, not the sentence, what he should have said would be, even if Ibrahim could live 10,000 years, still he would not have become a prophet. Because Allah has told you already that there is one who will know of that. That should have been the sentence used by him, or similar sentence. You see, you understand the point? If somebody, government tells you categorically that after somebody has been appointed the Chief Justice, That is the last chief, last chief justice which is going to be appointed. And no chief justice will ever be appointed after this. After that, his son is born to him and he dies. Can you say, had he lived long enough, he would have become a chief justice? You can't say, because that would be insane to say that. On the contrary, you should have said, this son has died early, but even if he had lived hundreds of thousands of years, he could not have become a chief justice. Because there can't be any chief justice after Mr. So-and-so. That would be the same thing to say. So exactly in the same spirit, according to some Muslim scholars of great renown and fame, the logic which Ahmed Sanasan used was this. He could never have said about his son that he, had he lived after him, he would have become a prophet. So the word after, in light of this tradition, should not mean in the sense of time at all. Because his begotten was very close to him, connected to him in time. So the time explanation is to be discarded in favor of the meaning of opposition and hostility or disagreement. I hope you keeping pace with me in understanding what I said, because your knowledge of English is slightly, you know, substandard. Please. But because you already know the Holy Quran and my some references of, so you tell you must have comprehended the meaning.
And only when you read about that's so it's very easy for me to understand. And it's logical, so the examples, I like the examples, it's very good.
Because then I have you know, comparing it in the light of the illustrations, then I saw your face lightened up and you began to understand me much better, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm glad to. Yes.
That is why I took so long, you know. I could have said the same thing in a shorter time. But because you were sitting before me, I wanted to make myself clear to you.
Yes.
Yes, please. Dr. Sahib? And should that be, I think that should be the last question tonight.
Yes, all right, sir.
Because 8:30 was the time when
I... Long time now, but 4 years ago, I think that I reached. I don't remember who is there. Brother Dila Kalano and Tumar were sitting in one place. And
Brother Dila Kalano
and Hadhrat Mirza and Hadhrat Mirza were sitting in one place. There will be the leaders of the young people of general, except if Nabi comes, he will be leader.
Well, I don't remember this tradition, but there is another tradition. That Abu Bakr of Cairo has a Yummate, Illa and Yabuna Nabi Yun. Yet Nabiyun is not used, the word Nabiyun is used. And that clinches the point for us. Because the word Nabi is Khabretana, not Ismetana. So the non-Ahmadis want to point out, want to drag this tradition in their favor. If you know the Arabic grammar, the inflections of the last word convey a very important message, and it's very important to understand the inflection in Arabic grammar. When it says illa an yakuna nabiyyan, it means Hazrat Abu Bakr to whom he is referring, and what he means is to say that Ibrahim Hazrat Abu Bakr would be is the best of this Ummah, except for the fact that he is not a prophet. You see? But if you recite, if you say the same word in the way Ahmed said, There you don't say Nabiyan, but say Nabiyun.